hundreds of, you know, calls and texts and emails from other fighters one on cards, and it's contagious, and it's only going to get bigger because Jake wants fighters to be taken care of, and you got to like that as a fellow fighter. You respect that. So to circle back to your question about the list, we'll see. I'm looking at one guy at a time. There's not too many guys on that list that scare me, to be honest, but a couple names, we still got a little work to do, but some of the names on that list in the boxing ring, line them up, we can really do it.
So, let me ask both of you guys, what's the biggest punch that Jake landed at you guys in camp? Anything that stands out?
Me? You don't land anything on me. I hold the mitts. What do you mean?
No, on the mitts. Like, where you're like...
I don't know. He has so many, so many great tools. You know, he has, you know, both hands, both sides. His angles, we've created for him with his fighter. Could be something for the crowd to see, something different. So, he has fire in both hands. I think his right hand, everyone sees that that's one of his most, you know, strongest shots. But I think if he has a chance to work his left hand a little bit more, as the fight continues, everyone will see that it's just as good.
Speaking of his list, his brother is on there. Have you guys been a part of, like, you know, in on those sparring sessions? Like, who's getting the better of who?
They don't spar.
They don't spar each other?
No. They never spar. No, they don't spar.
Not really.
Well, how you guys gotten that one, man?
You know who I got, but it's really me. Yeah, Jake, of course. But the thing about it is, like with Logan, I can't even. That would be the last name on the list, I would say.
Yeah.
Because I mean, it's family. You know, Greg and Pam. I'm just like, you know what I mean. The parents. I mean, I would get a lot of slack.
They've had their moments.
It's just like, you know, with Logan. Logan comes in to camp and watches Jake train. He offers a lot of encouragement. He comes in. It's like, I don't know. Like, that's. These brothers are sick. Trust me, they'll fight each other.
Yeah.
But to me, as a coach, I would rather just, you know, be like, hey, you know, maybe that's what we talk about, but maybe it never happens.
Here's one for you, BJ. Yeah. He's willing to fight his own brother.
Yeah.
If he calls you out as his coach, he wants to fight you. What would you do? I mean, listen, he's crazy about it.
We're taking a sick twisting turn. And we're going into left field.
That's all him, man.
We're going into left field here. I'm not going to answer that.
Reining it back in, Perry went on record to say that he sparred Jake and he got fucked up. Is that true?
Yeah, it is. But we didn't talk about it, you know? Mike Perry said that, and Mike Perry will admit that on his own admission. Look, me and Mike texted for a long time after that sparring session. He's like, man, I can't believe it. Like, that guy's, you know. And I said, hey, if you wouldn't mind, can we keep this kind of low profile and not really talk about it? And he was like, yeah, I figured you guys would be telling everybody, and you haven't told anybody. And the reason why we've been able to have success getting people to fight us and come in, people don't really know how good Jake is right now. And I'm not saying he's the next Muhammad Ali. I'm not saying that. We got a lot of work to do and a lot to prove.